फ्रेंड्स, टुडे लेट्स सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू सर्क्यूट थियरी और नेटवर्क थियरी इन 2017 तेलंगाना ईसीई ईसेट एग्जाम. सो थेवेनिन्स रेसिस्टेंस आर थेवेनिन इज फाउंड आउट बाय, जनरली थेवेनिन्स रेसिस्टेंस इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय ओपनिंग द सर्क्यूट बिटवीन स्पेसिफाइड टर्मिनल्स एंड इट एंड शॉर्टिंग ऑल द वोल्टेज सोर्सेस. If you see the options, so it is between open terminals known as RThevenin. Next, superposition theorem can be applied only to circuits having, basically superposition theorem states that it is only for linear system and including the subcategory of time invariant linear systems in which the response, it can be voltage or current in any branch of a bilateral linear circuit having more than one independent source will be equal to the algebraic sum of responses caused by each independent source. So if you observe, it is for only linear and bilateral elements. So in a series RLC circuit that is operating above the resonant frequency, the current will be, so when the frequency is greater than the resonant frequency, inductive reactance will be greater than capacitive reactance. So therefore RLC operating greater than resonant frequency will be behaving purely inductive in nature. So the phase difference between current and voltage will be same as in the circuit of a inductive circuit. Therefore, I can simply say current will be lagging the applied voltage. So if you consider the resistor, inductor and capacitor, so in resistor VR, it will be in phase, and in the inductor VL will be leading current, and in this capacitor VC lags current. This is the position of series RLC circuit. Next, to tune a parallel resonant circuit at a higher frequency, the capacitance should be, so if you observe an parallel RLC circuit, the resonant frequency FR will be 1 by 2 pi into root LC. Now what is he asking? To tune it to a higher frequency, so if this must be increased, automatically this capacitance, so if your fraction value is to increase, the denominator value is to be decreased. Next, the characteristic impedance of a transmission line depends upon, so characteristic impedance Z0 is determined by the geometry and materials in the transmission line for a uniform line, and it is not dependent on length. So the SI unit of characteristic impedance is ohm, and characteristic impedance of a lossless transmission line is purely real and it will not be having no reactive component. So if you observe geometrical configuration of the conductors is important. Next, so special transmission lines constructed with copper patterns on printed circuit boards that can be used as tuned circuits or impedance matching circuits are called, this is a definition of strip line. So strip line is specifically a transmission line based on planar microwave circuitry. It typically consists of conducting strips surrounded by dielectric material and sandwiched between two conducting ground planes. So the two ground planes, so this is ground plane 1 and you have a transmission line, and this is another ground plane in a substrate. So you have a substrate, transmission line and grounding. So you have a PCB like this, Next, with this, the questions related to circuit theory are completed in this 2017 question paper. So friends, let's solve questions related to circuit theory in 2018 Telangana ESET ECE question paper. So question number 111. So Kirchhoff's current law is based on law of conservation of charge. So the law is based on conservation of charge, where the charge is product of current and time. So if the net change in, if the net charge in a region is constant, then the current law will hold on the boundaries of the region. So KCL is based on principle of conservation of electric charge, and KVL is based on the principle of conservation of energy. So try to remember these two points. Next, in superposition theorem, while considering a source, all other voltage sources are generally, they are short circuited. So in superposition theorem, linear network containing more than two or greater than two or more sources, the response in any element can be, response can be voltage or current in any element, is equal to algebraic sum of responses caused by individual sources acting alone, while other sources are non-operative. So considering all the voltage sources are short-circuited and all the current sources are open-circuited. So remember these two terms. This is related to the internal impedance. Next, if the source impedance is complex, then the condition of maximum power transfer theorem is, so in an active network, it can be stated that maximum power is transferred to a load when the load impedance is equal to the complex conjugate equivalent impedance of the network viewed from the terminals. So this is the condition. Next, which of the following is not a transmission line? Cavity resonator is not a transmission line. So generally, transmission lines are used in various applications like telephones, power transmission, underground cables, and they are also used in traces of PCB and traces of multi-chip modules, also in integrated circuit packages. So what is a cavity resonator? It is one of the waves which exist in hollow space inside a device. It is used in electronics and radio and microwave cavities consisting of hollow metal boxes, which are used in microwave transmitters and receivers to control frequency in place to the tuned circuit, which are used for lower frequencies. Next, which one of the following theorem is used for analysis of transistor circuit at high frequencies? So Millman theorem states that if the impedance is connected between the input and output nodes in an amplifier having a reference node N, then the impedance can be replaced by two impedances, one connected between the input and reference node and the other connected between the output and reference node. Next, in an RC circuit, when the switch is closed, what is the response? The response will be decaying with time. So if you see this circuit, RC circuit, and you have a battery, so in this RC circuit, when switch is closed, the response will be decaying with respect to time, and the response V by R decreases with increase in time. So in an RC circuit connected to a DC voltage source, the current will be decreasing from its initial value I naught to zero as the voltage on the capacitor reaches the same value. Next, for reciprocity theorem, to satisfy the ratio of response to excitation before and after the source is replaced should be, so for reciprocity theorem, to satisfy this condition, it must be with the same. So the response of a circuit is current which is measured through ammeter, and according to the reciprocity theorem, voltage source which is the excitation and current response in which you are using an ammeter are interchangeable for solving the network, and the ratio of response to excitation is always constant as per reciprocity theorem. Next, for an integrating circuit to be effective, the RC product should be how many times the period of input wave? So when the RC is much larger than the pulse width, approximately 10 times your RC, if it's 10 times the value, then the output waveform will be resembling the square wave input signal. So when your RC is pretty much smaller, which is approximately 0.1 times RC compared to the pulse width, the output waveform takes a form of very sharp and narrow spikes. So if you see, this is the value. So for better understanding, I'll show you the diagram of it. So this PDF is available in the link provided in the description of this YouTube video. So this is your condition when your RC pulse width, how your output will be varying with pulse width. See how it is. These are narrow impulses when your time constant is less. Next, the Q meter will be working on, basically Q meter works on the concept of series resonance, because the resonance exists with the circuit once the reactance of the capacitance and reactance is of the same magnitude. They induce energy to oscillate in between the fields of electric and magnetic field of inductor and capacitor. So this is a standard question which is asked every year. So try to remember this. So with this, we end all the questions related to circuit theory in 2000 Telangana ESET question paper.